everyone! Welcome back to some more. There's a little thing. Okay. That thing's clear. Welcome back to some more Guardians of the Galaxy.
Feel that? Feel what?
Power in the air. I can feel it in my follicles.
Your follicles? Okay.
Yeah, Groot says his roots are tingling too. This place is dangerous.
Yeah. Yeah, this place is dangerous, dude. I mean, that's obviously. Looks pretty cool, though. Actually, this reminds me from Star Wars Rebels. There is an episode, or is there two episodes that there's been down there? Either one or two. It is a season finale. I won't get any more specific than that, but if you've seen Rebels, season finale.
Can we give him the ability to understand
not series finale.
Or respect personal
then you know what the place we're talking about.
I can think of a few words we can remove from his vocabulary.
But then he wouldn't be Drax.
So you're saying there's no downside?
Minus the color scheme. The color scheme is obviously different, but like if you look at the canopy stuff and then like
we're
the
here.
Yeah.
Home of the healing light, source of the cure, origin of Raker's power.
It's a cocoon?
Told you she was gonna feed us to some giant bug. Or maybe she's the bug, and that's some kind of
damn
external digestion sac or something.
And then two more references
realize
I get
this
here.
Is weird,
hold
right?
on.
Oh, it gets weirder.
Is Yoda's hut in Dagobah. The hut, not like all the stuff going from it, but that kind of looks like Dagobah's hut, or Yoda's hut a little bit. A little some of theirs. But then also, there's that cocoon in the movie Crawl. Crawl or Krell? Crawl, I think, with the chakra thing weapon. Made in the 80s with the young Liam Neeson. Neeson? Right? Yeah, Liam Neeson. There's a scene with a woman who spends her life in a cocoon that kind of reminds me of this a little bit. Not 100%, but a little bit.
What?
Oh, gross! Please tell me Drax is the only one who's got to go in that creepy egg sack.
So the shepherds found fresh flock.
What? What the fuck? Wait a minute. That's, is that the Adam Warlock guy?
Foolish followers.
Fast, beard butt!
Oh, damn. How the...
You know not the gravity of your treacherous trespass. You cannot quell a god. Prepare for oblivion, interloper.
Oh, it's this one. Okay, Green Meanie, you're up.
Found you.
Magus.
What wayward wickedness is this?
Nasty uglies from that busted noggin of yours. Okay, guys, it's him, Aaron Witchcraft. No, wait, Aiden Warsock, Ashley Warsock,
Adam Warlock.
That's it, the Golden God guy.
Hold on, this guy's Raker's old divine, whatever.
Looks pretty good for a dead guy.
Were you not sent by the sanctimonious shepherd?
Us? With Raker? Not a chance. We're trying to shut his ass down.
See, friends. Okay, big guy. In we go. Come on! All the ones where we die already happened.
Okay.
Oh. Raker's got half the galaxy going cuckoo bananas. Her friend included.
I swapped your ass for a newer, younger blue-skinned model.
So, can you help us? Mantis seems to think he can cure Drax.
My heavenly healing is veiled malignance. A first folly I swore never to repeat.
Can someone translate this guy?
He said no.
What protection I can proffer is to remain reclusive.
Not this time, Goldie. The pieces need to go back together. We just gotta get you all closer to the puzzle.
And that would be...
in here, of course.
What?
Whoa, wait, let's talk about...
What the butt?
It's like the beginning of Space Odyssey.
Welcome to the Astral Plains, Snorlord.
You teleported us?
Oh, no. You're still comfy cozy with me. I just merged your minds.
Merged our what?
I gave no consent to this, Planescaper.
She's not big on asking permission. It's all pretty sure this and Fate of the Galaxy that.
Don't you get huffy, God Guy. Your gold hands are all over this mess.
What's that supposed to mean? I thought this guy was how we cure Drax.
Cure and cause can coalesce.
Oh, this is Drax's head we're walking towards. Okay.
Guys? Is
oh my god.
Drax?
Hi, Groot.
So we're going into Drax's head. Literally.
Green Meanie's in there somewhere. Find him and convince him to come back to reality.
Mantis, please tell me we're supposed to be going into the bright light.
Pretty sure. You need to reach the heart of Drax's promise. Much deeper than I've ever seen.
Wait, if you've never seen it, does that mean it never happens?
Hope not. Just keep going. And if we lose contact, listen to Amy Winsock.
She means you.
Quite clearly.
Amy Winsock, huh?
This is Drax's promise? Mine was a lot less downery.
This is just the doorstep. Poor guy was stuck here, reliving the loss of his family.
Your friend's fear and pain primed him as prey.
What do you know about it, Goldilocks?
More than I mind.
So what did you do? Because he's the leader of Novacore, right? I don't really know anything about Adam Warlock. But I know that they made reference to Novacore's leader being the gold god, but then also... wasn't like Raker's leader a golden
contact?
I can't see past the surface. Something won't let me in. Where you're going, I may not be able to follow.
There's the big loot. That was easy.
This is just an echo, little fuzzy. Part of poor Greenie can never stop digging until he accepts what's there.
You're not the only one that hears that, right?
After him, Spongebob! I don't know this part!
Just Thanos laughing 24/7? Alright, let's do it.
Give me something, son! Drax?
Not Drax. Thanos.
Bet you weren't expecting a family reunion. Hey, Gamora.
Well, it's just an echo, right? Mega ability unlocks five barrel barrage. Conquering his traumatic fear of water to save his friends freed Rocket from all restraints. He'll now gleefully reveal the entirety of his massive arsenal and bombard enemies with bullets, missiles, and projectiles. Massive damage. So soften him up, try and stun him.
Hit him down, Groot!
And then...
Rocket, go wild!
Holy shit!
I'm so tough after all.
Something's not right.
You fail to fathom the rules of this realm.
What the?
Okay, that's...
now there are two of them.
That's new, right?
I think I remember there being two of them.
Twice the ugly, twice the target set.
Hey, Goldie, don't suppose you want to lend a hand?
It's like he can't be killed!
As far as Drax is concerned, he probably can't!
You're giving in to poor Greenie's obsession! Only by letting go can you move on!
Abandon the obsession!
Is that supposed to mean something to us?
I guess just die?
Can't just keep night! Can't!
Peter?
Whoa! Hey, what's happening?
That's it! That's why I couldn't see!
Okay. Oh, we got 7 points. I thought I had like 3.
Hey.
Although, can I even spend them anymore? Because we already have... We have all yours. Wait, Shield of Spartax? Oh, I know that's you. Yeah. I don't have Uproot, but I don't think I even want it. Drax shatters the ground, dealing moderate damage to one enemy and light damage to nearby. The thing is, like, a lot of these kind of do the same thing, but okay, I'll buy this, I guess.
We ain't dead!
Mantis, I think we did something, but I don't see Drax. Oh, good. Not creepy at all.
His daughter?
Hold up! Look!
I bet I could beat you to the center.
Are you so keen to usurp your father, little one? Not so fast, little one. Drax! Wait up!
Hold on. Wait, there's no way that I'm going to be able to find components inside of a brain, right?
Is all this Cathathian writing?
There he is again!
Drax, buddy! Wait up!
Forced to follow fools.
Damn it! I can hear you, little one.
You play pawn on a board built by your opponent.
You got a better idea? I'm all ears.
Go backwards, maybe?
If you're lost, you can say you're lost.
I'm just getting my bearings.
In this non-Euclidean nightmare maze.
Right.
Nope. Not backwards.
Hey, Goldie. You seem extra twitchy.
We are unwelcome and being watched.
It ain't the first time.
Oh, so I guess I went the right way the first time.
That's cheating.
I get the impression something doesn't want us to reach Drax.
Maybe Drax doesn't want us to reach Drax.
And I can't do my dash move in here.
Oh, assuming we ever catch him, what then?
I'm working on that.
Left, little one.
Huh? You can see me?
Your friend is too far fallen to be willed back by words.
For someone who's been no-help.
There! Look!
Hey, how did you beat me?
Because I am your father. You've been playing in your mother's garden again.
I was hunting.
Hunting dirt?
No, I chased it, but it was too quick.
Only fools rush forward. The hunter waits, chooses her moment.
Drax.
Papa, are you all right?
Drax, Camaria, it is time to come home.
What the flark is that?
Yes, little one. Your mother waits.
Insidious succubus, release your thrall!
But now he's getting in it.
He's not in Kansas anymore.
Yeah. Son of Shadow, snuff their source while I widen our way.
They're coming from those nests!
Go have fun, Rocket. Here, we're gonna do a little thingy.
I know! It's like they want me to keep blowing him up. And I gotta admit, every time they go splat, it paints an awfully nice picture. There's no way we lose today, Quill.
We are painting the battlefield right now, Rocket, in so many shades. But, too excited. This love fest, this dazzling euphoria, it'll all disappear.
Who's with me?
We are!
Great!
Wait. I died? Okay. I guess I was in the process of dying. What the hell? I don't remember being low on health. Oh shit, wrong. Okay.
Guys, huddle up.
Can we skip this?
We're killing it out there, Quill.
You see the look on their faces when they see me razoring down from high?
No, I guess not.
Or the ones they make when they realize Groot's got him tied up in a bow.
I know, never thought I'd say this, but fighting with you guys is fun.
Okay, yes. I get that it's all bubbly and sparkly out there. We're blasting shots at them and it's so much fun. But if we lose our focus, if we can't let go of these crazy thoughts spinning us upside down, we're done. Who's with me?
Nice one, Peter!
Feel bit!
Alright.
Look out!
There we go. Where's the other one? Oh, it's over here. Oh my god, there are a lot. Jesus.
Don't worry, pal.
No, hit the thingy. Fuck.
I have purchased.
There we go.
Prepare to be pulled within.
Hold on to your tails. Don't you dare. I ain't leaving wood chips out of my car.
Everyone all right?
Define all right.
I think we gotta look at whatever's keeping us from Drax.
Yeah.
You saw simply its spawn. That black stuff. I saw something like it in my promise.
There will be more. We have merely moved deeper within its domain.
Speaking of which...
Is that...
Drax's wife. I think so. Hovat.
Then this must be Drax's home.
You two certainly took your time.
Only fools rush.
Come, my love. Let us go inside.
Drax, buddy.
Your words are wasted wind.
Easy, all right. I got this. Come on, big guy. I know you can hear me.
Why do you haunt me?
We're gonna lose him again.
It's me, buddy. Stormlord, remember? We're all here.
You're stronger than this, Drax.
Come on, you big lug. Don't leave me alone with Quill.
Drax, dinner is ready.
That's not Hovat. You gotta let her go.
You do not know when you ask.
Damn it!
All right.
Here we go again.
All right, seek and destroy, just like last time.
Make haste. The maw means to snap shut. I cannot contain it.
Like a hot knife.
Yeah, trying.
Working on it. I'm working on it, promise.
Other one's over here. Can't go that way. Maybe it's time to fly.
Maybe hurry up to those nests.
Stop. All right, that should do it. Or not.
Oh shit. Oh shit. There we go.
Endless entropy. Ceaseless charade.
Cover your eye holes.
You are Groot.
Nowhere is where we are.
Maybe it's not all bad. I don't see any new promise, at least.
We are an empty eternal echo. Naked nothingness.
Not helping. Hobo wizard. All right, everyone just split up and look for a way out.
Hobo wizard.
Or forward, or whatever.
I lose a bet if I die in a dark pit.
It was alone in a dark pit, and you can't pay me for both dead.
Drax! Come on, buddy. I know you can hear me.
This ain't flarkin' funny.
I know you're in a dark place right now.
Literally.
But we're not gonna give up. Just point us in the right direction.
There! Look!
I can't believe that worked.
Let's go. Part of him is still with us, I'm sure of it.
I hope you go.
Oh.
Why are you doing this? Oh, not leave me be.
You gotta trust us, Drax. We're trying to help.
By destroying my home.
Your blissful ignorance is an ignoble pursuit.
Easy, Shakespeare. We got this.
Come on. You don't really want to stay in this dark hole?
I would endure the depths of Sarduth to be with my family.
Drax, love. It is time to eat.
Get it, man. They seem really special.
They are the only thing that matters. My Hovat was the most fearless mate I've ever known. She brought me peace even during times of war. My Camaria. My innocent little Camaria. She was the best of us both. Despite her meager stature, they both were. They were. Quill. My family is gone. What sits before me?
I don't know. It is not real. It ain't good.
It is a perversion, fed by desperation.
Without it, I will have nothing. I cannot be alone again.
You're not alone, man. We're here for you.
We've all lost someone, Drax. But it gets easier if you surround yourself with the right people.
I am Groot.
Groot said some mushy stuff. Let's just pretend I said it too. We're a team.
Papa? Are you okay?
Join us, Drax.
It's not her.
Are you hurt, Papa?
Talk to us, love.
Cherish the time that we had, and not resent the time that we lost. Shall love and honor you both. Always.
The hell?
How you doing, big guy? You okay?
I am a sound mind, thanks to you all. Amends for my lapse in judgment.
Hey, you don't owe us squat. Ain't none of us perfect. It's kind of our thing.
How much do you remember?
Great darkness grew with every lie that I swallowed. The longer I remained with my family, the more certain I became that I could never leave. Your Quill, your child is in danger. If her pain is half of my own, the darkness may consume her entirely.
Not if I can help it.
We gotta be smart about this. There's a whole lot of converted between us and her. A
whole lot of that black blorf, too. And anyone wanna tell me why Harry Hobo was able to suck it up?
Mortensen, why that thing looked like him?
Because it is me.
Well, he's changed.
Time to go.
I didn't want to talk at all in that scene.
Hey,
I was just kind of
Braun.
I was just watching the movie.
Explain that bombshell.
Time is tight and your understanding unimportant.
Can I shoot him? Come on, let me shoot him.
Hey. We're in this together, and Smart Money says it's gonna be a tough fight.
Imagine ambivalent omnipotence, drifting in darkness.
Speaking of dark...
Such was my celestial solitude.
What the hell?
Power without purpose, until uncovered by Raker. His crew were convalescent. Plagued by a pox, I was serendipitously suited to soothe.
A ship full of sick people just happens upon someone with limitless healing?
We were need and needed. Symptom and solace. They worshipped the wonder of my ways and declared me divine.
I think we know where this is going.
I do not know where this is going.
Shh! This is the scary part!
As the flock of followers fawned, a dark delight developed deep within me. And in the shadows it spoke. Weak whelps, pernicious priesting, feeble fools fit for feasting. Hubris made hunger. A cancerous craving called Magus.
What did it want?
Complete devotion. I too heard this voice and could hear nothing else.
Adulation. Flagellation, gorged with grief and consternation.
I told you this was the scary part.
It was pure putrefaction, sown from the seed of my strength. My soul's stone gone sour. I resolved to rip it out.
Rip it out? How?
A mechanical marvel wrought by Raker would sever the stone from my skull. and excise the evil entangled within.
Translation, you let Raker steal your powers.
Whatever his wayward wander, he was on that day my friend. He swore to separate sanctity from sin, that my healing could yet be harnessed without harm.
Sure, but who's harnessing it?
Sounds like you were careless.
Deluded by desperation. My mind was melding with Magus.
Did it work, at least?
In a savage sense. Split my soul in twain and cast us to the cosmos.
So, no.
For me, there was only darkness. I awoke half whole, certain the stone shattered. How Magus merged with another, I know not.
I think I can answer that. After I rejected my promise, I got pulled into Nikki's. Perel was there. She was trying to show me something.
Peter, you can't trust anything you saw in there.
This was different, and it felt different. She took me back to the QZ and I saw that Magus thing. I saw it get all twisted up with Nikki and I saw it kill Corell.
You hear yourself? How'd she show you this if she's dead?
Quite conceivable. Her soul may be snared by the stone, chained to the child.
That's what Corell said. The three of them are somehow connected. She said Nikki needs to accept her death.
Magus preys upon her pain, manipulates her mind while feeding on her flock of followers.
And I'm guessing it never gets full.
Its appetite is insatiable. If unassailed, Magus will absorb all.
We're gonna need one hell of a plan.
Well, you better come up with it quick, because I see daylight.
The bond between Magus and Matriarch must be broken. It harvests its hunger through the host.
So, Nikki's like the head vampire. If we cure her, it'll free the rest. Why didn't you just say that?
So step one, find Nikki.
Step two, convince her mom ain't coming back from the dead.
Step three, get that stone away from her and mop the floor with that Magus thing.
You show no shortage of assurance.
Yeah, this one's Mr. Positivity. It's enough to make you sick.
The stone is both bondage and bridge for Magus, and a young mind is most malleable. If Magus is merged with her, she may not survive the severing.
We won't let it come to that.
Not to join the Golden Downer, but how are we supposed to find the kid? What are you...
What's going...
Oh, Flark.
Okay.
They've got the Cortex. They can go anywhere, convert anyone. Now.
Why does that sound like you're not coming with us?
These are my people. Some still survive if I stay.
Then we'll stay and help.
Go. I'll be where I'm needed when I need to be. Just trust me.
Don't go dying on me. I'm starting to actually get you.
Man, it's been a cool 30 minutes.
You want to pop a squat, Golden Boy? You're making me nervous.
Or perhaps your nerves need gnawing.
What did I do?
This precarious plan proves more meek by the moment. The Madonna was meant to be among us.
She knows what she's doing.
Eventually.
Sorry, sins I have wrought to rest me among such a motley crew.
Is he taking my room? He's taking my room.
Did he take my room?
Not so much as a yip from the mic. Groot says he'll keep trying. Where's Mr. Fancy Words?
His assumed Peter Quill's quarters was a daring display of dominance.
Don't you start.
Usually I'd say who needs him, but we do. So you better fix this one, Quill.
Just try not to piss him off any more than he already is.
If it is to be a fight to the death, I will honor the outcome.
If he kills you, I get your guns.
What a bunch of lovely friends.
Wouldn't bet on Peter winning that fight. Took all five of us to beat him last time.
I still can't believe he caught one of my smart bombs.
Moore, are you okay letting Mantis fight the church alone out there?
She won't fight. She'll focus on evacuating people. Maybe they can all hide in the caves.
So she's just gonna let the church take over her homeworld?
Mantis will tell you that people matter more than the planet. And she knows that the church won't stop coming until we rescue Mickey.
You have great confidence in this celestial Madonna.
She's one of the few people I know I can trust.
Really? She freaks me
out. Why does it keep saying me?
She's smarter than you?
Hold kinder.
On. Maybe because I got a thing on. There we go. Does that take care of it?
That nickname makes my skin crawl. I'm furry, not fuzzy.
Nope.
Not even that little.
Close the refrigerator.
Did you just?
You have closed the refrigerator door.
Yeah, I do that sometimes.
I thought I was the only one who ever bothered.
I thought I was the only one.
Wait a minute.
I observed the tree closing at once.
Wait. Is it you then? Is Drax the one that always leaves that fucking thing open?
Glad you're back on our side, Drax. I got a feeling we'll need to go full destroyer on this one.
I should be ready, Peter Quill. I have witnessed the threat posed by Magus firsthand. No one should suffer from its malignant lies. I owe all of you a great debt of gratitude. It would be my honor to fight beside you with all of my might.
That's a lot of might. Groot agrees with you, Muscles.
Because like the llama wasn't on the ship
nice church butt-kicking
the first time the fridge was open.
I only hope our guest agrees to join this buttock striking celebration.
I keep going into this room.
In hand supply sustenance to this chamber. He's asking for room service now.
Come get your own. We've got a full fridge.
Well, not exactly.
Oh. Hey, sorry. I didn't mean to.
It is fine. Your company is always welcome. And thank you for the gift.
Oh, yeah. Sure. Figured you might want to light it from time to time in memory of your family.
Why would a lit candle remind me of my family? Every memory I have of them has been carved into my flesh.
You... What?
The red scars that I bear. They are a record of every great deed. An important milestone in my life.
Oh, they are?
Oh. I just thought it was because they look cool.
No, Peter Quill. On Katath, we practice scarification so that there is a record, proof, that one is worthy to enter Ul'tath. Such a record is required for judgment in the afterlife.
Huh.
So... Hypothetically speaking, if you died tomorrow, what would happen?
My Cho'tak, my life essence, would travel to the gates of Ul'tath. There I will be judged by the great kings and queens of ages past. And if deemed worthy, the gates will open.
And if you're not, you know, worthy?
The gates do not open.
And...
I am cast into Sarduth, where I will cease to exist.
Yeah. I guess that's bad. So, like, how do these kings and queens know if you're worthy?
By reading the scars that make up my life record. From that, they will judge whether I'm worthy. For some, a life of meaning comes from their trade. For others, their family. And others yet, from following the warrior's path. Each is a valid entry into the gates of Ultaf. Hence the record.
What happens if you don't have a record?
Like yourself.
Sure. Like me. What happens to someone like me? Do I just immediately get thrown into Sardouf?
No, Peter Quill. Your record is instead given by those who knew you in life.
Oh.
Ooh, yeah. I might have some problems.
Doubtful. I've seen your dedication to the Kree child and woman, and to this crew, and what you did for me. It is a testament to your worthiness.
Thanks. So, your tattoos are actually a record of your life that's been carved into your skin?
It's pretty cool. I don't think I knew that.
The process is known as the Jil-Tara, and is extremely painful. It requires focus and self-control, and occurs many times in a Catathian's life.
No offense, Drax, but they just look like a bunch of swirly lines.
Perhaps to you. To me, they are the most important moments of my life. Each line is composed of 1,000 scars, each engraved with the tooth of a walnut creature.
What kind of moments get recorded? Kill counts? Stuff like that?
No, Peter Quill. A Catathian life record is a record of just that. Major milestones and important events. Like the day I became a man.
Gross.
And the day that Hovat accepted my proposal of marriage. And later, the marriage ceremony itself. And the day that Hovat gave birth to my daughter, Camaria. And the day that I lost them both.
Now I see why they're scars.
Yes. Once I believed my failure to avenge their deaths had banished us all to Sardouth. But now, thanks to you and the others, I see a deeper truth. Life does not have meaning without suffering as well.
If anyone deserves a happy afterlife, Drax, it's you. Think you'll be adding any more to your tattoos?
Yes.
Like maybe a Guardians of the Galaxy logo?
Perhaps.
Good enough for me.
I like these little moments.
All right.
Oh, Gamora!
Since when do you meditate?
I don't, but desperate times and all. Stuff's been a lot lately.
I get it. How the help me do I get it?
So, how do you use this then? In case, you know, Rocket asks.
Well, for one, it isn't about just holding it. You also need a comfortable place to sit, where you can be relaxed but alert, and focus on your breathing. Then you practice. A lot.
Yeah. That sounds like a lot more work than I was hoping for.
Anything worth doing tends to be.
So how do you do it?
Focus was something Thanos beat into us early on. But it wasn't until I lived with the priests of Pama that I realized how limited his version of meditation really was.
Okay.
How did you end up living with the priests of Pama? They're not exactly your kind of crowd with the whole pacifism thing.
Mantis introduced me to them last year when I needed to heal. They helped me in ways I didn't think were possible.
Helped? How?
I guess you could say I was broken. Thanos, the war, working as an assassin. It'd take a toll on you. By the time Mantis brought me there, I was ready to give up. I mean, I was miserable. Convinced I was beyond redemption or worth, I truly believed I deserved to die.
But you didn't. Die?
No. There was this boy there. Akan.
The one you hugged in the village.
Akan was like me. Lost. His parents had died in an accident. He was combative, rebellious, the opposite of a pacifist. The priest thought it would be a good idea for both of us to work through our scut together.
And was it?
At first, not really. He was a pain in the butt. But over time, we came to rely on each other. Thanos had taught me how to meditate in the functional sense, but not in the spiritual sense. Like, how to work through my trauma, caring for Akan. He forced me to reflect and process. And together, through mutual support, Akan and I were able to overcome our demons.
Nice.
I can't picture Thanos meditating. I kind of always figured he was this egotistical tyrant.
No, he totally was. But Thanos also understood that aspects of meditation could be useful to his cause.
Like focus?
Focus, increasing overall awareness, pain tolerance. He came up with a series of exercises, fun little games for me and Nebula to compete in as part of our training. The worst part was, we didn't even know what he was doing until it was too late.
What do you mean?
Thanos' brand of meditation warped us, turned us into hyper-focused weapons. That way we were numb to the horrors of his agenda.
Killing people.
Assassination is just a different name for murder.
So how did you cope?
We made puns. Bad, stupid jokes to shout as we were killing people. The more terrible, the better.
Here, I thought you just had a really lame sense of humor.
Oh, I do. But it was the only way to survive. And it was something we did together, a new kind of competition, just between me and Nebula, to see who can make the other laugh.
That's really messed up, and yet, oddly endearing.
Yeah, well, even bad puns can only get you so far before your conscience catches up with you.
Wow. I had no idea meditation could be so intense.
Or beneficial?
Well, yeah, that too. I guess I should give it a go sometime. Although I'm kind of scared of what I'll find.
Who knows? You might surprise yourself. I know I did.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay. Well, I think I'm going to end this episode here, and then I guess we go talk to Gold Boy, and then move on to the end of the game, I'm guessing? So thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you on the next episode. Take care, everybody.